Rick Snyder, and I'd like to welcome you to PHY 110, an introduction to geology. I'll be your instructor for this semester. I look forward to a great semester where I get to share with you my knowledge of geology and teach you all about the Earth and how geologists work. The purpose of this video is to kind of just give you an introduction to myself. I'll let you guys actually see me because whenever I do the other PowerPoints, you won't see my face and stuff like that. But it's really the primary purpose is to introduce you to the course and introduce you to your instructor. So without further ado, let's go ahead and fix this up here, and let's go here. Okay, again, my name is Rick Snyder, and I have been teaching at OTC for approximately 9 years. Typically, I teach the seated course in astronomy as well as geology, but I've kind of started delving into the online world, and I really enjoy it. What I really like to do is, geology is my passion. That is my major area of study, and I look forward to kind of showing you guys how geologists work and what all goes into being a geologist, okay? So with that, I really hope that you enjoy the course. Please email me, you can contact me through Ask the Class, you can do anything. I love to answer questions. I may even delve into the world of maybe doing some live streaming. I don't know, I'm still working on this technology thing. This is only my second course that I've taught in the online setting, so I'm still learning some things. So I do, in advance, appreciate your patience and understanding with all this. Okay, so let's go ahead and go with this. All right. Well, as you can see, getting to know me, you kind of can see that I do love the outdoors. I've traveled extensively, and I've started traveling even more more recently, and I really like getting outdoors and hiking and just, getting out and looking at nature and geology. Some of the things about me, like hobbies and stuff like that. Well, first of all, I'm kind of a workaholic, so I consider that a hobby. By day, I am a high school teacher at Kickapoo High School. I teach the Earth and Space Science courses, so I teach, of course, Earth Science Honors, which are both dual enrolled through Missouri State. I also teach Meteorology, which is dual enrolled through Missouri State. I teach Intro to Astronomy, which is dual enrolled through OTC. I also teach physics as well as forensics. So as you guys can kind of, I'm very busy. I'm one of the only instructors at the high school level that can teach multiple courses like that. So I'm pretty fortunate in that aspect that I can teach several courses. Okay, other things that I like to do other than hiking and camping and stuff like that, excuse me, I do like to trail run. Trail running is something that I've kind of picked up more recently. I've done some trail races, and then, life got in the way and got out of it, but I am starting to run again. Actually, I'll be running tomorrow. And other things that I do like to do, I play softball, I play basketball. I just try to stay active. That's pretty much what I do. Used to be big into cycling, got out of that, but other than that, though, I really enjoy my work. I enjoy teaching. I've done it for 15 years at Kickapoo, and like I said, 9 through OTC, and I look forward to many more years of teaching, so I absolutely love my job. Okay, enough about me. I don't like talking about me. Oh, well, hey, look at there. I don't like talking about me, but now what you've got is I want you to actually see my credentials. I do have a Bachelor's of Arts in Secondary Ed from the University of Wyoming. My degree is in Earth and Space Science with a minor in Biology. I do have my Master's degree in Secondary Ed Earth Science from Missouri State as well. As I mentioned previously, I've been at Kickapoo High School for the last 15 years. That's been the one place that I've really, really enjoyed. I like working there. I currently teach Astronomy and Geology at OTC. Both seated and online. This semester, I am strictly online. I've blocked it out there with my video, but I've taught at Missouri State. I taught Earth Science for Teachers, as well as I've taught meteorology at Drury University. I also spent 10 years in the U.S. Navy before I went back to school and got my degree. So I've been kind of well-traveled and everything, so and you know, I'll share some of those great geologic things that I've seen that it was so cool. I mean, like, I've climbed Mount Etna and Sigonella, Sicily. It is one of the coolest things, like, ever. Okay. Other things, I do have some research background. Now, I do apologize that I'm blocking this out. I'll fix that at a later date. But whenever I do research, I actually do scientific research with high school students. As you can see down there on the bottom, very broken up, is I do integrate college-level research into a high school curriculum. That was some research that I did. That was what my, that's how I obtained my master's, by doing how I integrate college-level research into a high school setting. It's a great, it really gets students excited about research. We have a research, I was kind of in the group that kind of started a science research class at OTC. Of course, I don't teach that because I just simply do not have the time to do that. But it's really something that I think can really turn students on to science, is whenever you're doing authentic scientific research. Other things we've done is ground penetrating radar imagery of the Wablo Osceola impact site. I've also done GPR imagery of the Haviland impact site in Kansas. But most recently, the top two ones up here, these top two is, I've done all these with high school students. This is really what's going on, is I was their mentor for all these. But the top two are very important, because what we've done with those is pretty significant. What we've done is we've come up with a method to differentiate primary craters from secondary craters. Of course, on the moon is where I do a lot of my research now. With this, whenever you start looking at lunar research, I'm in a NASA program where I get high school students in competitions where they're presenting their scientific research, which is, of course, the top two. What really happens, though, is that they're doing and conducting my research, and then I let them present it. So they kind of take it over, and I give them the idea, and it's just been, it's been a great, let me see, I've done that for 5 years now, and every year we are rock solid in that competition. Now, the stratified ejecta boulders, that is my most recent one, and that one is awesome. My students did an amazing job, and what ended up happening there is they ended up winning and getting this actual research published. So I have three high school students that are currently attending Drury University, Missouri S&T, and Western Colorado University, majoring in areas related to either engineering or geology. And it's one of those things that's really cool. It's also published. You know, they have a published research journal. So it's kind of neat to see. Okay. All right, just so that you guys can actually see some what you're, you know, required to have for the course. Of course, you're going to have your textbook, which is Essentials of Geology. Absolutely love the book. It's a great resource. It's what I would call an easy read. It really fits my teaching style, which I'm still developing in an online setting, but it does fit my teaching style. So you're going to find that it's very beneficial in helping you to do what I ask of you. On the right there, of course, you also have to have Mastering Geology. Mastering Geology is a code that you have to either purchase if you haven't purchased a new textbook, or you actually get it with a brand new textbook. I think it's like $32, $34. I haven't bought it in so long that you know, I even forget, because now I'm just I just consistently get it renewed. So it's that with Mastering Geology. What you can do there is it's questions that I feel really address the concepts that I'm going to be discussing with you. So, in a sense, it is a great study guide. Okay, so keep that in mind whenever you're doing these Mastering Geologies. You guys will see some examples of what I expect you to do. I try to make this a really good class where I always say that like we're playing a game of Clue. So I'm going to teach you all the clues, and then I'm going to give you like these challenges to say, okay, can you figure out what created this landscape? So, or what this material is. So you guys will, you'll pick it up, and mastering geology sets a good foundation for doing that. Okay? Another thing that you're going to have to purchase is what is called the Coastal Learning Introductory to Physical Geology Lab Manual for Distance Learning. You can see what this is it's a whole big box that you'll be purchasing. You can't obtain it from the OTC bookstore. What it does is it contains materials and things that you can actually have a hands-on setting. The best way to learn geology is through a hands-on setting, and then, you know, through an online setting, that makes it very challenging. But what this box actually does is it provides you a good, something that you can actually touch and be like, oh, I totally get what the, you know, what he's discussing now, or what he's talking about, because I construct my labs pretty much around this box setting. Now, you won't use everything in here. I have tried to make it so that you do use as much as possible, but what we'll do is we'll kind of go through it, and you guys will see some things. Some of it will just be for practice, to kind of say, okay, this is stuff that's going to be on the exam. Other things are going to be within the actual labs. So you'll kind of see how that's structured there, right in the first three labs. Okay, one thing I do want you to know is, and through an online setting, it's very, very important, is you have to read the textbook, okay? Reading the textbook is going to give you a foundation that says, okay, this, I know what these words mean. I know what they are. I have great this book has great pictures in there. I have PowerPoints that basically supplement the actual textbook. Now, is it verbatim? No, I don't really teach that way. What's going to happen is you guys, as you progress through the course, you're going to see that basically I'm going to try to teach you how to be a geologist. Okay. Now, all I'm really going to be focusing on is introducing you to the realm of geology, the science of geology, and kind of give you an appreciation of what geologists actually do, okay? So don't freak out. It is going to be challenging, which is great, because what it does is it keeps you into the course. It's like if this were just an easy, what I would call blow-off course, and you know what I'm talking about, you guys would be like, okay, I'm really bored with this. I hope you don't get bored. That's my primary goal, is to say I don't want to be bored. It's like, wow, that's actually cool. I never thought of that. So I'm going to try to, you know, set you up with things that actually excite you about geology. Okay? But reading the textbook is actually very important. Then I would go to the PowerPoints afterwards, and I am recording videos. I may not record every video. I found some great YouTube videos that can do animations and things that I can't even come close to doing. So I'll just post those. Okay? So that's what you're looking at there. Of course, again, I apologize for this, setting this up like this with the video, but please make sure that you read the syllabus. If you find something in the syllabus that you're like, okay, what is he talking about? Please go through, ask the class, or you can just simply email me and say, okay, I'm not really understanding this. I've picked up, you know, I've kind of increased my load a little bit of teaching. Like I said, not only do I teach all day, but then I've picked up an additional course. I am also teaching PHY 100 in Intro to Astronomy, and that's why these videos are so late, so I do apologize for that. But I'm kind of getting going, and I'm learning new things with online, and I'm trying to make my course a better course for you. So again, please read the syllabus, because it does have all the dates in there. If I've left something that says 2015, because I did some copying and pasting, please tell me so I can go back and fix that to 16 and make sure that you understand exactly what's going on. Of course, one of the primary things that we have to worry about is always the proctored event. The proctored event is the final exam. I'll give you more information on how to schedule that proctored exam through either OTC or through Proctor Hue. So we'll talk about that much later in the course. Next thing, because I really need to stop saying but the next thing that you need to focus on is, please, to really have a good understanding and how and have a good experience in this course, you really do have to have knowledge of how to use Blackboard. You do have to use knowledge or have to have knowledge of how to navigate through things. I'm going to have you guys, there's going to be some sites that you're going to go to that are not associated with OTC. They're associated with like websites that have you do activities on there to supplement your learning. So understand how to download things, how to do this. And one thing that's really nice is you can email either online OTC or you simply email the help desk. They do a great job of actually saying, okay, here's how you can do it. They provide you direct links to videos on how to do things. So they've already got all that implemented. So please use the help desk and OTC online by emailing them, and they will give you everything that you need to know. Because I necessarily don't know how to access a lot of things from a student perspective. That's why. I can flip to a student screen, a student view screen, but it's not going to be exactly like yours, so it's a little bit more difficult for me. And I've never used Blackboard at OTC as a student. Okay? Okay, other than that, I'm looking forward to a great course. This right here, this is what I normally look like. This is because I'm getting old, and these are good old reading glasses. So, at times you'll see some videos of me and everything. Just realized that I am wearing the reading glasses because age has crept up on me. I'm on the envelope of 50. Okay, so I hope you have a great semester. I look forward to teaching you guys about as much as you want to know about geology, and it's going to be a really interesting class. So please go ahead. You guys can, this is the end of this video. What I'll do is I'll be posting the other videos for the lectures, and I hope you have a great semester.